Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the creep and sinkage in the concrete structures. First we go with the creep. Creep is time dependent deformation of concrete under the permanent load and permanent displacement. When concrete is subjected to compressive load, it is deform instantaneously. This immediate deformation is called as instantaneous strain. Now, if the load is maintained for the considerable period of time, concrete undergo additional deformation even without any increase in the load, and this time dependent strain is termed as creep. As it is saying that when we keep the load on a concrete structure for a longer period, what will happen? Even if we are not increasing the load, but what will happen after a certain period? It will go deformation with the same load itself. That deformation we consider as the creep. So here are the some of the factors affecting the creep. First, concrete mix proportion, aggregate properties, age at loading, curing condition, cement properties, temperature and stress levels. We go one by one detail. First one is concrete mix proportions. The amount of paste content and its quality is one of the most important factor influencing the creep. The poorer the paste, structure undergoes higher creep. Creep increases with increase in the water cement ratio, as here indicating that it will be mainly depending upon the how we are preparing the concrete mix paste, right? If we are adding the more water, what will happen? It will be increasing the greater creep because of the water will create the voids. When it evaporates, you will get the wires which are present in the cement or this concrete structure. So due to the loading, it will be compressed and it will be increasing the creep. And also, creep is inversely proportional to the strength of the concrete. All the other factors which are affecting the water cement ratio are also affecting the creep of the concrete. Next point is aggregate properties. Aggregate undergoes very little creep. It is really the paste which is responsible for the creep. Aggregate influence the creep of concrete, so the resisting the effect of magnitude of creep. If we are using the better quality of the aggregate, it will be your creep of the concrete will be very less. If we are using the poorer quality aggregates, so due to this, what will happen? Creep will be increased. And also, what if we are using the wider aggregates? So here, strength of the aggregate will be very less, and it will be undergo easily more creep. And the higher the modulus of elasticity of the aggregate, lesser will be the creep, as modulus of elasticity directly proportional to the quality of the aggregates we are using. Lightweight aggregate shows sustainable higher creep than the normal weight aggregates. Next is age at loading. Age at which concrete member is loaded will have a predominant effect on the magnitude of creep. The quality of the gel improves with the time, such as gel creeps less. So gel, when it will be performed, when it will be reacted with the water, and cement will be reacting with the water, and it is preparing the gel, right? So if a gel quality is improved, in that case lesser will be the creep. And whereas anger the gel undergo load being not stronger, the creep will be more. As the anger gels, so anger gels, when it will be, when your fresh concrete it is there, or the not much curing, it is proper curing here and done. At that time, if your concrete is loaded, in that case, creep will be more in the concrete structures. Next is moisture content of the concrete being different at the different age also influence the magnitude of the creep. Here, moisture content, we cannot say that it will be same for the continuous lifelong of the concrete structure. As the moisture content, depending upon the moisture content, creep will be also varying in the concrete structure. Right? Next is, here in this graph it will be showing that strain on the y-axis and the time since application of the load in days. Here, as the load increases, our creep is also increasing. Right? At the certain time, when I release the load, what will happen? It will be going to instantaneous recovery after, but it will not go for the total recovery of its length. Right? So that recovery, only it will take the certain instantaneous recovery, and again, so that the restraint structure will be continued. So next is curing condition. In view of smallness of creep strain, the amount of water expelled during the creep from the micropore into the micropores must also be small, probably much lesser than the 0.1% of the volume of the concrete. Here what will happen? It will be depending upon the amount of water which is expelled, which is removed out from the micropores of the concrete. So it will be very less compared to the volume, that is less than the 0.1% of the total volume of the concrete. Right? Larger the curing, smaller will be the creep. That means if you give the better curing to the concrete, it will give the lesser the creep. Next is cement properties. Type of the cement affects the creep in so far as it influences the strength of the concrete at the time of application of the load. Fineness of the cement affects the strength development at the early age and thus influence the creep. Finer the cement in the higher gypsum requirement, so that regrinding of the cement in the laboratory without addition of the gypsum produces an improperly related cement which exhibits the higher creep. So this is the relation with the creep factor and elastic strain to calculate the creep. So epsilon CR, that is the creep strain, is equal to elastic strain, that is epsilon EL, into creep factor, or is equal to stress in the concrete divided by elastic modulus of the concrete at 28 days into creep factor. Using this formula, we can calculate the creep of the concrete. This graph is showing the duration of the loading and total elastic and creep strain in the concrete structure. This line is showing this is the instantaneous deformation, and these are the points which are showing us the 7 days duration of the loading, 14 days duration of the loading, and as the time increases, our creep is also reducing the for the as the as an loading time duration is increasing, here creep is also reducing. Okay. Next is our shrinkage. Shrinkage is shortening of the concrete due to the drying and is independent of the applied load. Shrinkage of the concrete is the time dependent strain measured in an unloaded and unrestrained specimen at a constant temperature. So in case here what is happening, our volume of the concrete will be shrinked out due to the evaporation of the water content in the concrete, water content in the fresh concrete, and its volume, size of the concrete will be reduced, shortened. That this is called as shrinkage of the concrete. So here there are mainly three factors which are affecting the shrinkage, that is drying condition, time, and the water cement ratio. Drying condition, the most important factor is the drying condition or the humidity in the atmosphere. No shrinkage will be occur if the concrete is placed in 100% relative humidity. If we place the concrete structure in 100% relative humidity, that is we are keep the concrete member completely immersed in the water, so we will find the zero shrinkage, because as chemical reaction will be take place, heterogeneous heat will be generated in the concrete, but that heat will be replaced or reduced by the curing water surrounding in the concrete structure. So here we will restricting the shrinkage. Okay, next is time. The shrinkage rate will decrease rapidly with the time. It has been documented that 14 to 34% of the 20-year shrinkage will occur within 2 weeks of its being produced. At the initial stage of the concrete itself, you will find the shrinkage of the concrete. So whatever the shrinkage would have been occurred at the age of 25 years, it will be occurred within the 2 weeks of the produced, and within 1 year of the concrete being produced, shrinkage will be about 66 to 85% of the 20-year shrinkage. Next is water cement ratio. Water cement ratio will influence the amount of shrinkage that occur. The concrete richness also affects the shrinkage. The process of swelling and then drying effect affect the concrete integrity and the shrinkage. Here some of the types of the shrinkage. First is plastic shrinkage. Mainly will divide into four parts: plastic shrinkage, drying shrinkage, autogenous shrinkage, and carbonaceous shrinkage. Here we will study in this video first two shrinkage, that is plastic shrinkage and drying shrinkage. Plastic shrinkage, it happens soon after the concrete is poured in the forms. So the water evaporates and results in the reduction of the volume. This causes the concrete on the surface to collapse. The aggregate particles or the reinforcement come in the way of subsidence, due to which crack may appear at the surface or internally around the aggregate and reinforcement. So whatever the aggregates and reinforcement which are coming in between the shrinkage process, so at that time what will happen, we will find the cracks on the surface of the concrete or on the periphery of the aggregate or the reinforcement. So higher the water cement ratio, badly proportioned concrete, rapid drying, greater bleeding, unintended vibrations, etc. are the some of the reason for the plastic shrinkage. So here we are seeing that water cement ratio, badly proportioned concrete, rapid drying, greater bleeding, unintended vibrations are some of the main reason for getting the plastic shrinkage. Plastic shrinkage can be reduced mainly by preventing the rapid loss of water from the surface. It can be reduced by covering the surface with the polythene sheeting immediately after the pour. So it can be reduced by maintaining the water content from the at the surface of the concrete, and also we can reduce the plastic shrinkage by immediately covering with the polythene sheet of surface of the concrete. Second is drying shrinkage. Just as the hydration of the cement is an everlasting process, drying shrinkage is also an everlasting process when concrete is subjected to drying condition. The loss of free water contained in the hardened concrete does not result any appreciable dimensions change. It is the loss of water held in the gel pores that causes the change in the volume. So drying shrinkage mainly occur when after the hardening of the concrete, whenever our internal moisture content in the concrete, hardened concrete, is start evaporating. So at that time our concrete starts shrinking. It is very less amount of shrinkage you will find in the as the drying shrinkage, and it is a continuous process. As long as the hydration process is going to take place in the concrete, so at that till then we are going to find the drying shrinkage in the concrete. Under the drying condition, the gel water is lost progressively over the long time, as long as its concrete is kept drying condition. Magnitude of drying shrinkage is also a function of the fineness of the gel. Finer the gel, more is the shrinkage. It has been pointed out earlier that the higher the pressure steam cured concrete with low specific surface of the gel shrinks much lesser than that of the normally cured cement gel. Okay, this is what the introduction of the here in this video we have seen that creep, factors affecting the creep, shrinkage, types of shrinkage, and factor affecting the creeps. Okay, thank you.